नमस्ते नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम टू सेकंड पीयूसी फिजिक्स क्लास. वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मूविंग चार्जेस एंड मैग्नेटिज्म, करेक्ट? नमस्ते, वेलकम टू द क्लास. वी हैव रीकैप्ड ऑल द फॉर्मूलास रिलेटेड टू मूविंग चार्जेस. एनी मूविंग चार्ज विल प्रोड्यूस अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो इफ इट इज मूविंग इन अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, so it will produce a magnetic field, and the existing magnetic field, they interact and the force acts on the charged particle, that is given by QVB sin theta and all the things related. Now I will remind two formulas and I will move forward. That is, today I will deal with the force between two straight parallel conductors carrying current. Suppose you take two straight parallel conductors carrying current, for example the current carried by that electric line. So it is something like infinitely long straight parallel conductors. Compared to the distance between the conductors, the length of the conductor is very large. The distance may be 1.5 feet or 2 feet, but the length is very large. So such a conductor, if you take and if you pass current through those two conductors, DC current I am talking, what will happen to that? Both will produce magnetic field, right? There will be a magnetic field in a straight conductor carrying current, and if you want to find out the magnetic field direction, you have to clasp it with the right hand. You know it. And if such a conductor is placed very nearby another conductor that is also carrying current, and both the conductors will produce magnetic field, that magnetic field will make the two conductors either to attract or repel. And when it will be the attractive force and when it will be the repulsive force, that's what you have to find out. Okay, we will take two straight parallel conductors, and before that we have to have two formulas within us ready, always ready. One is magnetic field due to a straight conductor carrying current and at a point very close to its midpoint. It is an infinitely long straight parallel conductor. What is the magnetic field here? Here it is B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi, then 2i by r. You can cancel this 2, mu naught by 2 pi I by r. You can write it like that also, or mu naught by 4 pi 2i by r. So that is a magnetic field at a point very close to a straight parallel conductor carrying current, like this. Another formula. Force on a current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field. So if you have a straight parallel conductor placed in a magnetic field, and if the straight conductor is carrying a current I, and if theta is the angle made by the conductor with the direction of magnetic field, and if B is the magnetic field direction, then F is equal to B I L sin theta, right? Or I into L cross B, that is also possible. So I will rub this here, so that it is a just explanation of force. I don't want it in the vector form. F equal to BIL sin theta. So these two formulas are very much needed to analyze the next case. Now we will take two straight parallel conductors carrying current in the same direction. They are very close to each other. They are infinitely long. So I will draw the straight parallel conductors like this. One is here, this one. Yeah, and its thickness is very small compared to its distance between the other conductor, distance from the other conductor. So this is another conductor like an electric line, but it should carry a DC current. So of negligible cross-sectional area they are. So these two are the conductors, and say they are infinitely long like this, okay, and they are separated by a distance D. Say this is distance D. And they are carrying current IA and IB. So this is IA, and the current here is IB, but in the same direction. So two straight parallel conductors carrying current in the same direction, and they are infinitely long, are placed side by side, are separated by a very small distance D, small d. Now what happens is, now each conductor is a conductor carrying current placed in a magnetic field. See here. Each conductor is a conductor carrying current placed in a magnetic field. It should experience a force. Sir, where is the magnetic field? If you ask me that question, where is the magnetic field? Magnetic field is produced by another conductor, because this conductor is in the magnetic field produced by this one here, and this conductor is in the magnetic field produced by this one. So mutually they are producing magnetic field on one another. This is carrying current, so it is producing magnetic field. In that magnetic field, this is existing, and this is carrying current and producing magnetic field like this, and in that magnetic field this is present, and both are carrying current, so both must experience force. And how will be the direction of the force? Whether it will make the conductors to attract each other or repel each other, that's what you have to do. Okay, now what you can do is you can apply Fleming's left hand rule. Current carrying conductor, its length, and BIL sin theta. Okay, first of all, you have to apply clasp rule. Where is the magnetic field in the region of B or A? Anything. Now, let us try to find out what is the force on the second conductor, B. If you want to know what is the force on the second conductor, you must know what is the magnetic field in the region of the second conductor. Suppose this is the second conductor B, it is placed in a magnetic field. That magnetic field is produced by A, right? So clasp A. Clasp A it like this. So the conductor is like this, it is existing like this. I think you can follow this one. The conductors are existing like this, right? Straight parallel conductor. You have to clasp A. When you clasp the first conductor, the thumb showing the direction of current like this, the fingers will show the direction of magnetic field like this, like this, like this. By the time you reach this other chalk, other conductor, it will be like this, downwards, right? It is downwards here. So this conductor is clasped with the right hand such that the thumb shows the direction of current, then the fingers will show the direction of magnetic field and it comes down. So clasp this conductor, clasp it with right hand, it shows the fingers show the direction of magnetic field. So it will come like this. Like this, like this, like this. By the time you reach here, it will be like this. This is the direction of magnetic field. But remember, this is the magnetic field in the region of B produced by A. So this is the magnetic field produced by A. Because this is the conductor carrying current and that is producing a magnetic field encircling fingers like this. Right? So it is in downward direction. Okay, magnetic field is in the downward direction. Like this, BA, it is produced by A. Current is flowing along like this. This is the direction of current, that is IB. Now this is a conductor carrying current placed in a magnetic field, correct? This is a conductor carrying current but placed in a magnetic field. Shouldn't it experience a force? Yes. Fleming's left hand rule. So clasp rule to find out the magnetic field direction. Fleming's left hand rule to find out the direction of force. If the first three fingers of the left hand are stretched mutually perpendicular to each other, with four fingers showing the direction of magnetic field, middle finger showing the direction of current, then the thumb shows the direction of force. Now you see, field is upwards, right? Field is inside, of course. If the conductor is going inside the board, it is like this. Current is forward. Yeah, it is like this. Can you guess? It is like this, right? Middle finger is forward, it is showing the direction of current, and the thumb, this forefinger is downwards, magnetic field, then the thumb shows like this. Can you imagine it like this? So it is like this, right? So this middle finger should come in because current is flowing in. Can I show it in some other way? Like this, right? Now it is correct. Current is going in, magnetic field down, then the force is shown inside. That means the force acting on force acting on B, and that is due to A, the magnetic field due to A, FB, force acting on B. Hope you have followed, right? It is like this. You can see that. So you try to do this. Don't simply look into my Bharatanatyam. What you have to do is, you have to do it yourself, right? You have to do Bharatanatyam in your room, in your house. So we were doing this in the classroom a few months back, but now the time has come to do it through the videos, right? So whatever it is, so you can enjoy it, you can do this like this, right? Okay, so this conductor tries to move towards this one. Now what is this force? That's what you have to write. And if you want to write it, what is this BA? You should get ready with what magnetic field produced by A in the region of B. This is little confusing unless you know what you are doing. If you know what you are doing, of course, nothing to confuse. Otherwise, you should be very careful. You see, we are finding the magnetic field produced by A in the region of B, which will affect the B, right? Which will make the force to act on B. So, what is the magnetic field in the region of A? In the region of B, that is produced by A. It is at a distance of D, right? What is the magnetic field due to a straight conductor carrying current at a distance r apart, mu naught by 2 pi I by r? So what is BA? Can you write what is BA? Magnetic field produced by A at a distance d where another conductor b is present, mu naught by 2 pi I by d. Same formula, mu naught by 2 pi I by d, that is ba. Now what is the force acting on the first second conductor? Force acting on the second conductor, and what I will do is, one thing I have forgotten here, I will take only L length of the conductor. How do I take L length of the conductor? Only this much. Say from here to here. Here to here. Only L length of the conductor. That is, length is L. Take only L length of the conductor. If you take only that much, let me make the diagram a little bit clear. Yeah, like this, like this. I will take L length of the conductor. When I take L length of the conductor, what is the force acting on the L length of the conductor? Force acting on B due to A. Okay, I will write FBA. That is equal to mu naught, what is this one? BIL sin theta. You can use this expression. BIL sin theta. Now, if you want to substitute for this formula, what is B? B is the one which is created by A. The magnetic field of A is influencing B, correct? B is the one which is passing through A. And what is I here? I is the current through the conductor. Which conductor you are expressing? B itself. Current through B, right? So this current carrying conductor is placed in the magnetic field which is produced by A. So magnetic field of A, current of this conductor itself. L sin theta. What is theta? Theta is the angle between it is L cross B, right? F is equal to this. If you want to write this in vector form, F is equal to I into L cross B. It is the angle between L and B. Magnetic field is like this. Like this. L is like this. So it is 90 degrees. So sin 90 is 1. This is sin 90. So what is the force on B due to A is equal to BA, write the formula for BA, mu naught by 2 pi I, which I? Okay, I have not written which I. This magnetic field here is created by this conductor. So IA, mu naught by 2 pi IA by D into, so this is over. Correct? Mu naught by 2 pi Ia by D, magnetic field produced by this here into Ib into L into 1, sin 90 is 1. So what is the force on B due to A? Force on B due to A is equal to mu naught by 2 pi Ia Ib by D into L. What is the force? Okay, let it be like this. Sir, won't the conductor A experience a force? Of course, this part you need not write in the exam. In the examination, it is enough if you write only one part. One force is enough. Then you are saying, similarly, another conductor, A, also experiences force due to the magnetic field produced by B. So that force is also given by FB. F on A due to B, FAB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi, IAIB by L, IAIB by D into L. So same formula holds good, no problem. Now, how it is so? We will do that now, right? So that in the exam, you can write only one part. Both the parts you need not write. Another one is same. That's what you have to mention in the exam. Now, what is the force acting on A? Now, who is responsible for the force acting on A? Of course, B itself. B is producing magnetic field. And that is in this region. So if you clasp this with right hand, such that thumb shows the direction of current, then the fingers encircling will show the direction of magnetic field. The encircling fingers will come like this, and by the time it reaches here, the magnetic field is like this, right? It is going up. So, I'll show the magnetic field like this. This is BB. Magnetic field produced by the conductor B in the region of A. How is the current? Current is moving forward. IA. Current is forward. Now, what will be the direction of force? Again, Fleming's left hand rule. Fleming's left hand rule says, if the first three fingers of the left hand are stretched mutually perpendicular to each other, with four fingers showing the direction of magnetic field, middle finger showing the direction of current, thumb shows the direction of force. So how will be this? Yes, right, current should be forward, right? Yeah, this is correct? I think I am correct, right? Middle finger forward, thumb upward, and force is given by, middle finger forward, like this, four finger upwards, magnetic field, thumb shows here. So force on A due to B, it is like this. Force on A due to B is like this. What is this type of force? It is attractive force. That means two conductors carrying current in the same direction attract each other. Two conductors carrying current in the opposite direction repel each other. That is the final conclusion. So, two conductors carrying current in the same direction placed parallel to each other should attract each other. Now, what is the BB, magnetic field produced in the region of B, in the region of A by B. How can you write it? Magnetic field produced by B in the region of A, that is equal to mu naught by 2 pi I, which is producing magnetic field, yeah, this one, I B by D, correct? Quite opposite to this. Here the magnetic field is produced by this conductor. So the characteristics of this conductor has to be placed. Mu naught by 4 pi, current through this conductor and the distance to the other conductor. Mu naught by 2 pi I by D. Now, what is the force acting on conductor B conductor A due to conductor B? Force on A due to B is equal to, you know, force is equal to BIL sin theta. B, who's B? BB, right? Magnetic field produced by B in this region. I, current to the same conductor, IA, right? BI, L, sin 90 once again, because I into L cross B, L and B should make an angle of 90 degrees. The length of the conductor is like this, magnetic field is perpendicular, it is 90 degrees. Magnetic field is upwards, it is like this, magnetic field is upwards, and the length of the conductor is like this, they make an angle of 90 degrees. So, what is the final answer? FAB, force on A due to B is equal to BB, what is the magnetic field produced by B in this region? Mu naught by 2 pi. IB by D, and this is over for this one, and IA L sin 90. Force on A due to B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi IA IB by D, correct? It is same as this one, into L. This is the total force acting on L length of the conductor. I have randomly selected L length of the conductor. So, the opposite signs say that force on B due to A is equal to minus force on A due to B, right? It is quite like Newton's third law. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Action and reaction are equal and opposite. They act on different bodies. So, this is the formula, right? Force on A due to B, force on B due to A, they are in the opposite direction. That means two conductors carrying current in the same direction, they attract each other. So, you just change the direction of current and find out what is the force direction. You will find that they repel each other. If you want, you can do that now. So, if you you need it, I will do it again because it is very much needed. Of course, when I go for video classes, I need not do it again. You can rewind the video and you can check it again. So, that is not like a class. We have teachers have advantage. You can rewind the video, you can do that again. But I will try to put it in different ways. So, it is the two conductors carrying current. One is P and current is IA and this is another IB. I call it as conductors A and B. They are separated by a distance D. And I take L length of the conductor only, right? This distance is L. And so this conductor will produce magnetic field in the region of A, right? So how will be that conductor? Or IA will produce the magnetic field in the region of B. So clasp this conductor with the right hand such that thumb shows the direction of current. Then the remaining fingers will show the direction of magnetic field like this. Of course, you need not mention this in the final exam. It comes like this, so it will be downward here, right? This is the direction of magnetic field produced by A in the region of B. How is the B carrying current? Forward like this. B, current through B. So what is the Fleming's left hand rule? Magnetic field downwards, middle finger upwards, that means like this, carrying current, thumb shows inside. Force on B due to A. So how to write the formula? First you have to write BA, magnetic field produced by A in the region of B at a distance D. What is the magnetic field due to A? Mu naught by 2 pi IA by D, because first conductor is carrying current. Mu naught by 2 pi IA by D. Yes. V naught by 2 pi I A by D. Okay. Then, force on B due to A. Force on B due to A is equal to I into L cross B, I L B sine theta. That is the formula. Which I? Force on B, right? Current through B only. Magnetic field produced by A. So, that is what you would write. That is it. Implies force on B due to A is equal to IB, L length of the conductor, BA here we have here, magnetic field produced by A, mu naught by 2 pi I by D, IA by D, sine 90, because magnetic field and this one, L cross B, that is 90 degrees. Length of the conductor is like this, element. Now, so what is the force on B due to A? Force on B due to A is equal to mu naught by 2 pi IA IB by D into L. Sine 90 is 1. And similarly, in the examination, you can write simply, similarly, another force acts on A due to B, which is given by mu naught by 2 pi IB, IA IB by D into L. Of course, it is of opposite sign, but I didn't put any vector here. I did not take the negative sign. If I had put vector, then I should have written negative here, because the FAB is equal to minus FBA. Now, here, that derivation doesn't stop here. Obtain an expression for the force acting between two straight parallel conductors carrying current in the same direction. That may be the question. After deriving this, you will be asked to define 1 ampere. Define the SI unit of current. SI unit of current is 1 ampere. How do you define that 1 ampere? You define it like this. So, using the force between two straight parallel conductors. Now, what I'll do is, I'll write the force per unit length. Force per unit length. You know that this force is the force acting on a length L. What is the force per unit length? Suppose this is 5 meters. This is the force on 5 meters. What is the force on 1 meter? Divided by simple L. So, what will be the formula? Force per unit length. So, this answer for this one is should have the unit Newton. Now, force per unit length is FAB by L. You bring L here. That is the force per unit length. Mu naught by 2 pi IA IB by D. That's all. And this answer should be in Newton per meter. Why? Because it is the force per unit length. Hope you can see this. Oh, you can't see this, huh? Okay, what about this? Here onwards you can see. So, this is in Newton. This is Newton force because you can't see this, right? So, this is force per unit length. And what about this one? Force per unit length. I'll write it somewhere else. Okay, I'll rub this. Force per unit length. Where is it? I want a chalk. Yes. Force per unit length, F by L, FAB by L, that is F, is equal to, you bring the L here, mu naught by 2 pi IA IB by D. And this has to be given the unit Newton per meter, because this is Newton, by L is Newton per meter. So, using this formula, you have to define what is 1 ampere. That is, and that completes 5 marks for this question. So, you have to define 1 ampere and finally you have to finish it. That is very important definition, because the definition doesn't go so easily. And one more thing you have to mention it here. Two conductors carrying current in the same direction. We call it as like currents. Current in the same direction. Like currents attract. Unlike currents, two conductors carrying current in the opposite direction, they repel. Unlike currents repel, like currents attract. As if you have like charges repel, unlike charges attract. That is the opposite criteria. Here we have quite opposite nature. Like currents attract, unlike currents repel. So, force between two straight parallel conductors. I will put the conductors like this now. Two infinitely long straight parallel conductors separated by a distance d. Then force is given by force per unit length. F is equal to mu naught by 2 pi IA, current through the first conductor, IB, current through the second conductor, divided by D, distance between the conductors, so much of Newton per meter. because this is not simple force. It looks like F, but it is not simple F. It is a force per unit length, FAB by L. Now define 1 ampere. What is 1 ampere? If you want to define 1 ampere, you pass 1 ampere current through these two conductors, whose cross-sectional area is negligibly small, very thin conductors, so that distance between them cannot be compared with the thickness. Thickness itself should not cover the distance between the two conductors. Thickness is very small and the distance is large. So consider two straight long parallel conductors, infinitely long parallel conductors, separated by a small distance. Force per unit length, that means what is the force acting on 1 meter length of the whole wire? Force per unit length is given by mu naught by 2 pi IAIB by D. Okay, force per unit length is so much. Now, if it is so, now take IA is equal to IB is equal to 1 ampere. Let the current flowing through each of the conductor be 1 ampere. And let distance of separation between them be 1 meter. Let this be mu naught, that means they are kept in air, free space. Otherwise, this would have been mu. What is called mu? Mu is permeability of the medium. As if you have permittivity of the medium in electrostatics, electric field and charges. We have, when two charges are separated by a certain distance, what is the force of attraction or repulsion between them? That is directly proportional to the product of charges, inversely proportional to the square of the distance. It depends on the medium also, epsilon naught. That is called permittivity of the medium. More the permittivity, lesser will be the force. Similarly here, this is air and permeability is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. You know it. Mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. So if you substitute the values, what you will get? F is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 into 1 into 1 IA into IB divided by 2 pi into distance is 1 meter. This is 1 meter, this is 1, this is 1. Okay. What is F? Yes, F is equal to 2 into 10 to the power minus 7. Remember again, it is not Newton. Newton per meter. Because F by L, force per unit length. F may be the symbol, but we have force per unit length. Now define 1 ampere. By substituting IA and IB as 1 ampere, that means by allowing the 1 ampere current through this, we were able to get a force of 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton. By passing a current of 1 ampere through these rods and by keeping them in vacuum, otherwise we would not have got this answer. This answer is obtained since we have substituted mu naught as mu naught only, not mu. It is some other medium, means it is mu. Only by substituting mu naught as 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, we were able to land here. So what is 1 ampere? 1 ampere is that steady current, that DC current passing through each of both two infinitely long straight parallel conductors of negligible cross-sectional area. If you cut this, what the area of cross-section they have, that must be very small compared to the distance. So 1 ampere is that steady current flowing through each of two infinitely long straight parallel conductors of negligible cross-sectional area, separated by 1 meter, right, placed in vacuum, which produce a force of, or repel with a force of 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton per unit length, or 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton per meter. That is the whole definition. Shall I write it, right? So better you write it. Take a paper and try to write it, because very, very important definition, derivation, for 5 marks. You have very little things to write, but very technical points. Why the conductor A has to be clasped while you are finding out the force on B? Why the conductor B has to be clasped so as to find out the force on A? So that AB combination is very important. F equal to BIL sin theta, but B due to A, I due to B only. So these combinations, very, very important. Similarly, the definition. There may be a chance of going wrong in the definition. You might have forgotten to say that they are placed in vacuum. 1 mark gone out of 5. See, only thing is you have not written is vacuum. 99% of the words are seen, only 1% is not seen. But what about marks? 99% mark is given? No. Mark is only 75% out of 5, sorry, 80% mark. Out of 5, you will get 4. 80% mark is gone. 20% mark is gone. Only 80% you will get. So, 1 ampere is that steady current. Steady means DC. Steady current flowing through 1 ampere is that steady current flowing through each of two infinitely long straight parallel conductors. 1 ampere is that steady current flowing through each of two infinitely long straight parallel conductors separated by 1 meter parallel conductors of negligible cross sectional area. I thought I have some criteria I have left with. Of negligible cross sectional area. That means if the conductors are separated by 1 meter, their thickness should not be half meter. Then the distance becomes a problem. Negligible cross sectional area separated by 1 meter. In vacuum, underline this. In vacuum, we usually forget it. In vacuum. So 1 ampere is that steady current flowing through each of two infinitely long straight parallel conductors of negligible cross-sectional area separated by 1 meter in vacuum producing a force of 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 newton per unit length. That means per meter. So 1 ampere is that steady current flowing through each of two infinitely long straight parallel conductors separated by a distance of 1 meter placed in vacuum of negligible cross sectional area placed in vacuum separated by 1 meter producing a force of 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 newton per unit length, or newton per meter is enough. So this definition is very, very important. And the derivation is also important, but very technical. If you are calm minded, then only you attempt it. If you are disturbed mind, then it doesn't give you a correct answer, because some or other writing A and B will make you go wrong. You may lose the mark. But very, very technical derivation. You must know why you are clasping A, what are you finding out on B, how is the force on B, how is the force on A, which magnetic field is disturbing the other one. So all these things, right? But this definition you have to write it. So 1 ampere is that steady current flowing through each of two infinitely long straight parallel conductors of negligible cross sectional area separated by 1 meter in vacuum or air producing a force of 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 newton per unit length. So even if you leave this, you will gone, even 1 mark gone, 4 marks, because definition has so much of weightage. So two infinitely long, you may get a 1 mark, 2 mark question also. Two infinitely long straight, what is the nature of force between two infinitely long straight conductors carrying current in the same direction? Two like currents, say, it is the force is attraction, attractive force. What is the nature of force between two conductors of unlike currents? Repulsive. You can see that the force is repulsive. I can draw the diagram and I can show you. So rough sketch is enough for me now. Suppose there are two straight conductors. You can check it yourself. You do that yourself first. Okay? After completion. Say the two straight conductors carrying current in the opposite direction. One is like this, another is like this. So IA, IB. Okay? Clasp this conductor with right hand so that the thumb shows the direction of current. Fingers will show the direction of magnetic field like this. Right? Like by the time it reaches here, magnetic field is like this, correct? I don't write anything here. So, like this, say, this is magnetic field due to A, this is current through B. Now, Fleming's left hand rule, middle finger current and magnetic field down, right? Will it be shown like this, correct? Magnetic field coming out, current coming out, magnetic field downwards and the thumb shows like this. Can you guess? So you have to start your Bharatanatyam. Take a paper and do that. Don't watch my video. Just do it yourself, right? That's very important. So current forward, magnetic field downward, force to the outside like this. This is the force on B due to A. Now, what is the force on A due to B? Yes. How will you find out the magnetic field in the region of A? clasp the first conductor, second conductor with the right hand. Of course, you have to clasp it like this. Like this, not like this. Why? Current is coming out. So it should be like this, correct? So clasp the conductor B with the right hand such that the thumb shows the direction of current. Fingers show like this, right? So magnetic field is like this. How it will be here? It will be downwards. So by the time it goes like this, like this, like this, like this, it will be going down. So if you have two conductors like this, right, current is coming out here. Current is coming out of this. So clasp this conductor like this. So how will be the magnetic field? Magnetic field will be like this, like this, like this. By the time it reaches here, downwards. Hope you can follow it, right? So like this, two conductors. Okay, clasp this with the right hand. I can show it like this. Okay, clasp this with conductor with right hand so that the thumb shows the direction of current. It is downwards. So here it is downwards. This is magnetic field. Is it so? Here it is downwards. Here it is downwards. It's magnetic field at A due to B, right? Due to B. BB. Now, is it so? Current upwards, magnetic field downwards. How will be the thumb? Will it be easier for me like this? Yes. Current inside, magnetic field downwards, thumb shows the direction like this. Force on A due to B. Very well. So two unlike currents, simply saying, two unlike currents repel, two like currents attract. And that answer 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 Newton per meter and definitions are very important. Hope you will do that, right? So we will stop at this moment because this is a very important derivation. Better you write it once and send it to me. You do one thing. You study this derivation because you see one thing I want to say you that the opening of the classes are very uncertain. It is going away and away. As we feel that we are approaching towards the opening of the class, suddenly it moves away. Now everything is moving away and away. So better you study all these things without wasting time. Because once the classes start, we don't know with what speed it will move, right? Everything, academic activities will move. I think this year you are going to have an incident which is faster than the speed of light. That is academic activities. Once the classes start, everything will be going beyond the speed of light. So better you study all these things properly now only so that you will have relaxing time during the college hours. So you write this, study this and write it once or twice or thrice left to you. And send it to me, WhatsApp number, right? Better you do that. You do this activity because these things, whatever you study in the second part, modern physics, of course, you can study it at the last moment and you can write it. But this part is not such an easy thing to study just a day before the examination. You won't remember it. Just a day before the examination or the previous night if you study it, next day you will never remember anything. So you have to do that again and again and again, then you will remember this. So write this two times, study it and write it two times and without looking at the notes, send it to me for this one. So this is today's activity. Thanks for watching my class. Hope you will do whatever I say. Let us not waste the time. Take care of your health at the same time and we will meet in the next class. Thank you.